Hey guys, so my resolutions have changed dramatically throughout the years. No longer am I looking to lose the last 5 pounds. I mean, who wouldn't want to? But I'm more focused on strength training and feeling good about my body. Since the birth of Connor, who you might be able to hear, I have been struggling to get my core strength back. So I'm gonna challenge all of you guys to try doing this 10-minute ab workout 3 times a week to get back your core strength. All right, here we go. We are going to be starting down on the ground and we're gonna be warming up our core. We're gonna start with a modified plank because we are gonna be doing some plank work. But if at any time that I'm doing one of these moves, if you wanna come down onto your wrists versus your hands, I will let you know if you have that option. All right, we're coming into a forearm plank to start. Here we go in 3, 2, 1, let's go. So right now, I know I said this was a little bit of an advanced, but we're just warming up our core. So you're exhaling, pulling your belly button in, and we are trying to form a straight line from our knees to our head. If you are really advanced, you could do this in a regular full plank. We are just warming up our core here. We've got 5 more seconds. We're gonna push up into a high plank in 3, 2, and 1. So you're gonna come up into a high plank. You're gonna be right knee, left knee, lower down. Give me 1 push-up. Come on up. Down, push up. So if you are more of a beginner and this is a little bit challenging, you could try just giving me a mini push-up and maybe your knees don't quite touch your elbows. You got 30 seconds in. And if you're advanced, maybe you don't come onto your knees for that push-up. We're building heat, 15 seconds. We're gonna come into a forearm plank in 10. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Forearm plank. And we're gonna come into a dolphin. So regular plank, lift up into that dolphin, come on back. Dolphin. So really all we're doing here is we're drawing our belly button up towards the ceiling, and then we're coming back to starting. So you wanna feel like you have a string on your tailbone. It's pulling you up. 15 more seconds. Keep drawing your belly button in. Last 5, 3, 2, and 1. High plank. Hold it here for 15 seconds. Exhale, you're coming off those hands in 10. You could add in a mountain climber here if you want an extra challenge. 4, 3, 2, and 1. Shake out those arms. We are gonna come into a side plank in 5 seconds. Quick little reset. Here we go. 3, 2, 1. On up. We are here for 40 seconds. You can come like this. Hand here. You can lower that bottom knee for a modification as well. Or come on up, 20 seconds. You guys got this at home. If you've got a light mat, you might wanna fold it over a few times. Last 10, my abs are shaking. Here we go. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Switch sides. Your shoulders are probably feeling challenged. So side planks are pretty safe to do during pregnancy. You might want to lower down on that leg. You guys at home are doing awesome. This is a challenging workout, but it's doable. Halfway there, 20 seconds. Stay long and lean. Keep reaching up and out of that shoulder right here. We're coming onto our backs in 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Quick little reset here as I adjust my mic. All right, come back down onto the ground. Legs go long.
Reach your left leg down and reach up. Right leg down. If you have a diastasis recti, this might be one of the first moves that you need to modify. And I would say, don't let that leg come all the way down to the ground. If you want a more challenging move here, both. But if you have a diastasis recti, definitely don't take that advanced option. You've got 10. Coming into the 100 in 3, 2, and 1, right here. Get those shoulder blades off the mat. Feet can remain in tabletop position. They can go up to the ceiling or you can lower them down. And we're just gonna pump our arms here. So basically, you're trying to flatten your abs. Pretend like you're almost patting water with your hands. Exhale for a count of 5, and then inhale for a count of 5. Each time, you're pulling your belly button on in, trying to flatten your abs. They should not be forming a cone at all. And what that means is that would mean that your abs are coming like this. Keep going. You've got 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Let your head come down for a hot second and rest. We are going to straighten that leg. Shoulders come up, exhale, and switch. So try to get those legs straight and use your core to really not move at all when your legs are switching back and forth. So pulse it 1, 2, 1, 2. Each time you're exhaling, you're drawing your belly button into the ground. We're gonna come back onto our hands for some more plank. Last 10. Five, four, three, two, and one. Quick reset as I adjust my mic. All right, we're coming back into that plank. We are gonna first start with a high plank, and we are gonna alternate right knee to left elbow and back. We're not here long. So in the beginning of your postpartum journey, you might not be able to get that knee to your elbow, and that's okay. Last 15 seconds. Coming into a forearm plank. In 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. We're gonna modify it. We're gonna be on our knees. We're gonna lower down into that forearm plank and then come back on up to standing, or rather high plank. We're gonna alternate. Which arm brings us up? 30 seconds. Last 2 minutes. You've got this. Abs pulled in. Five, four, three, two, and one. We're coming back onto our backs. Roll on down. Give me a C curve. Arms come up. You're holding it here. Exhale, pull your belly button on in. We are gonna alternate arms coming up by our ears in 10. Hold it here. If you're not shaking, maybe lower down a little bit of an inch. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. 15 seconds, just like this. We're gonna finish with a 45 seconds of a hip lift. Exhale, pull your abs on in. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Lift up and lower.
I'm gonna do the full extension. If you have a diastasis, you're just gonna go right here. You're just gonna lift up. If you are a little bit more advanced, legs can come all the way down and then up. Pick your poison. I'm 5 months postpartum. I'm taking that next level, but just because I am doesn't mean that you're ready. Every person is different. Tailor this workout to where you currently are. Last 10. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Rest. Awesome job. So you did it, 10 minutes. It's all it took. That was hard and you powered through. I know I am sweating. I'm sure you are sweating at home as well. If you want a more challenging workout, do this one more time through. Your goal is to do this 3 times a week, the month of January. Let me know how strong your abs feel by the end of the month. This workout should start to feel a little easier, and that's when you should take the more challenging option. Don't forget to check out my other pre and postnatal workout videos. And also, I now have audio workouts on Move With, where you don't actually have to watch a screen. You can just listen to me in your ear while you're at the gym. I have a free 7-day trial code down below. Awesome job today. I'll see you guys soon.